So sharing my screen. Okay. Okay, fine. So we are going to learn LWC Lightning Web Component. Previously, you know, you might have seen Aura components. So how, in what way the LWE is, you know, a little bit different than Aura component and why it is popular. It is recently introduced in 2019. You know, from variable resources, you know, a lot of openings for LWC. The experienced people is really less. The people with, you know, web technology background can able to easily grasp the things in LWC, Lightning Web Component, because it's purely based on web technologies only. Okay, there is no framework involved. Okay. So as far as LWE is concerned, you know, don't think that LWE is only specific to, you know, to Salesforce. Actually, you can create. Ritu is joining again.
Yeah,
that's okay, fine. So as far as LWE is concerned, you know, you can create LWC. You can use LWC to create even Node.js applications also. Okay, I will show you how LWC is being used in, you know, different ways. Let's say you want to create a simple Node.js application and you want to host it in Heroku, in the sense, you can able to develop using LWC. There is no Salesforce parties involved. So generally, LWC is a mechanism you can make use of it to create web-based kind of applications using LWC. There is no, you know, component or framework actually involved. So that is what the major difference between, you know, Aura component and LWE is all about. So it's a lightweight, because it is being in the, you know, Lightning Web Component is, you know, web technology based. It is a lightweight framework and it follows web standard. Okay. So web standard, in the sense, automatically it involves, you know, JavaScript part, it will have HTML part, it will have the DOM processing elements. So everything will be there. So better performance and compatible with Aura components. Compatible with Aura components in the sense, you can include an you know, an Aura component into your LWC, and you can include LWC into, you know, you can have it inside Aura also. So it's a compatible and easy to maintain. So that's a general. So in the 2014 web stack, you know, in the 2014 actually Aura components is released. You know, in the right side you have the framework. Okay, so in the framework, in the sense, you will be having data services, UA component, component model. So these all are the different kinds of, you know, concepts being used in the framework. Just look at the web standard, it looks, you know, pretty simple. Just ECMAScript 5, or currently ECMAScript is at 10 is now. ECMAScript, in the sense, it's nothing, it's a, you know, web standard. Okay, it's a European Computer Manufacturer Association. That's what, you know, ECMA is all about. It is a standard. Based on the standard, the JavaScript development is being happening. Okay, so ECMAScript 5, 6 or 7, currently it is 10. So these all are the main core part of your LWC component. It follows a web standard. So in web standards, you will be having JavaScripts and you will be having events, standard elements will be there, and it will be rendered into the screen. So it's pretty simple when comparing to your, you know, Aura component thing. So ultimately, at the end of the day, you are going to, your requirement will be, you have to create a Lightning component. So you will be having two choices. You can create a Lightning component either using Aura, or you can create a Lightning component using a LWC. The two choices are there. So now these days, the new components are being built in LWC because of its, you know, the web standard. So people are using it rather than Aura. It doesn't mean that Aura is out, Aura is there. Okay. So based on the requirement and based on the, you know, the time frame, how fast you need to develop a component. So these all are the things deciding, you know, whether you have to go for Aura or LWC. The blue parts are, you know, all about Aura. Okay. So as we discussed, it's a framework. It's a framework in the sense, it will be having different pieces of, you know, technologies built inside that. As far as web standard is concerned, it's pretty simple. So again, the same thing is going to be there. Okay. So advantages of LWC is concerned, it's a more standard thing than it's a less framework. So because of being less framework, it's better performance and browser compatibility. So any browser can be able to process your Lightning Web Component. There is no restriction that, you know, you should have a Chrome, or you should have, you know, Netscape, or you should have Firefox. So nothing is there. So it supports, you know, all the browsers. So that's a browser compatibility. So being in a web-based of kind of thing, so you can be able to easily learn. So that's the thing. And faster debugging, you can debugging the LWCs even comparing to Aura. It's really very easy to debug your LWC component. So as a LWC developer, you should know how to debug your, you know, so your component or your flow. So you should know how to debug. Okay. So as far as web apps is concerned, a web application generally consists of this following pieces of information. Actually, you will be having a HTML part, you will be having your JavaScript, you will be having your CSS and any server-side program. So at the end of the day, your web application or your web component, whatever it may be, it is going to reside in your server only, that is in the Salesforce server only. From the Salesforce server, you know, as people, those who have already attended, you know, our classes might know about that client-side programming and server-side programming. Okay. So as far as Apex is concerned, it's a server-side programming language. The Apex codes will be processed by Salesforce, Salesforce runtime environment, and it will be sent back to the client. As far as your client, client is concerned, it is your browser. Your browser has the capability of processing HTML, JavaScript, and CSS. It can't process a Apex programming language. Okay, so that is what the capability of browsers. Any browsers can process HTML, CSS, JavaScript, or plain text. As far as, you know, HTML and CSS is concerned, it's an, you know, to create the user interfaces. You will be using HTML and CSS to create user interfaces, or it is rather than you can set it as a markup. So the markup can be done using HTML and CSS. So as far as the JavaScript is concerned, to give some kind of dynamic way of doing things in the client side. Client in the sense, again, in the browser. Okay. So in the client side, if you want to do some kind of dynamic kind of stuff there, in the sense, you will be going for JavaScript. If you want to do the dynamic thing in the server side, in the sense, you will be going for server-side programming language. So generally, web apps is concerned, you will be having server-side programming concepts and client-side programming concepts. Server-side programs, maybe it may be a Java, it may be a Python, or it may be Ruby Rails, or it may be your Node.js. Okay, so whatever it may be an Apex, whatever it may be, those are all the server-side programming language. So this is what all about, you know, web apps is concerned. Okay. As far as the LWC is concerned, so let me show you the LWC, actual LWC website. Okay, so this is the steps. This is actually, you know, a LWC's official page. Okay, so using this LWC, you can simply create a simple web application. There is no need to, you know, it is related with Salesforce. If you have, you know, Node.js installed, okay, actually Node.js, in the sense, it will provide you a server-side, you know, runtime environment for JavaScript. So JavaScript runtime environment, this Node.js is all about. So it is built on, you know, using Node.js. So when you simply create LWC app, there is a Salesforce, there is a LWC CLI. So you can use it using, you know, simply create a LWC app, in the sense, you can able to easily create a simple lightweight web component in a fraction of seconds, and you can test it immediately. There is no need to have, you know, Salesforce or something else. So this is what about Lightning web component is concerned. In Salesforce, this particular, you know, web standard is being followed. This technology is being followed by Salesforce to create the Lightning web component in Salesforce. Okay. So generally, LWC is, you know, it's open. Anyone can use it to create LWC, to create any kind of web-based applications very fast. Okay. So that is what LWC is all about. When you have a free time, please go to this particular website and go for these kinds of things, you know, what LWC is all about. And in the LWC, you know, see here, it is partnered with your Salesforce. Okay. So LWC generally used to create a web-based application. Okay. Okay. Now, as far as, you know, Salesforce is concerned, when you're going for LWC based application, in the sense, you need to have a couple of pre-requests available there. You need to have a couple of pre-requests available there. One is a Salesforce CLI. You need to install Salesforce CLI in your system. That is a command line interface. So you can get it from this particular website. You can able to get it, Salesforce CLI. You can download and you can install it, the Salesforce CLI. You can able to install it. You can go for download. If it is 32 bit, you can go for it. And if it is 64 bit, you can go for this particular 64 bit version. You can find out whether Salesforce CLI is, you know, properly installed or not. You can go for SFTX -- version, in the sense you will be getting the version installed in your system. So by doing that, you can make sure that it is, you know, installed or not. You can confirm that. Okay, so this particular SFDS is, you know, it's installed. Again, you know, see here, the node version is also coming up. So node will give you a runtime, you know, server-based environment, JavaScript runtime environment. So as far as these days modern technology is concerned, Node.js plays, you know, a crucial part actually. So the next requirement, you have to install latest JDK, you need to install Java. And after that, you have to go for Visual Studio. Visual Studio is free, actually. You can install VS Code. VS Code is one of the, you know, very powerful editors being used. You can use VS Code to create, you know, Salesforce application. You can create the now VS Code support SOQL also. SOQL also, you can able to, you know, develop and run it in your VS Code. And generally, VS Code can be used to create Node.js application. And if you are going to build a mobile-based application, in the sense, you know, you can install a Flutter extension and you can go for Flutter development in VS Code. It's really a very powerful tool, one of my personal tool too. So it's really a beautiful tool. Okay. And after that, you need to, you know, make the things a little bit better. You will be going for Salesforce extensions. What is mean by Salesforce extension, in the sense? Let's say this is my VS Code editor. So once you install the VS Code editor, here you will be having the extension pack, okay, the extension manager. When you come over here you will be having, you know, different kinds of extensions. Actually, these are all the extensions already available in my system, okay. So these all are related with the Salesforce kind of stuff. And I have a bracket pair colorizer. So I have, you know, React.js extensions. So I have Dart extension. So what are all the programs in programming languages I used to do in VS Code? I used to have the extensions. Okay, let's say Salesforce extension, in the sense, one of the very, very basic requirement to build Salesforce in VS Code, okay, which make it easier for you, is the Salesforce CLI integration, or you can go for Salesforce extension pack. So these days it's better to go for Salesforce extension pack. So only this particular extension is enough to install, you know, all the stuff in a single extension pack. Let's say you can go for, you know, Apex. If once you install the extension pack, it will support you to create your Apex programming. It will support you to create Aura components. You can go for, you know, Lightning Web Components, the CLI integration, everything will be comes into the picture. So it's better to install Salesforce extension packs initially. Apart from Salesforce extension pack, if you want your VS Code, you know, to do the things a little bit neater, you can go for bracket color colorizer. So this is not specified in the documentation. This is an extra thing. Bracket pair colorizer, in the sense, when you put your brackets, you know, see here, when you put your brackets, it will be highlighted. As a developer, when you are going to write, you know, more than 100 lines of codes, in the sense, the intention, the tabs, as well as the colorization, where it started, where it is closed, it's really pretty important for us. So you can install this kinds of, you know, bracket pair colorizer. And one more important thing, Git also you can able to include it. And prettier, this is also you can able to use it. So this is a pretty code formatter tool. This you can also install. Okay, I have so many extensions. So these are the, you know, basic extensions as a developer who is going to use VS Code. Okay, so this is what being told in the documentation, I guess. So that is what extension is also about. Extension, in the sense, let's say if you're going to build a tag, in the sense, if you put lightning -, in the sense, automatically all the syntaxes will be coming up. So that is because of an extension. So it is better to always to go for extensions as a professional developer you are. Okay. So, and then how to create the projects, all the things we will come a little bit later. So this is the CLI command line interface. And when you go for SFDX version, you can able to see, you know, what version is being installed, and you can check it out the plugins also, what are the plugins being installed. Okay. And then first time when you are going for it, you can go for in SFDX update, because sometimes there may be new releases might be, you know, available for you as far as Salesforce command line interface is concerned. Okay, so command line interface in the command line interface is concerned, you will be using your command prompt to create the projects. Okay, to create the LWC project, to run the project, you will be going for SFDX command line. To make this, you know, instead of typing all the things in the command line, SFDX, create project, SFDX, you know, create LWC component. So for each and every command, there will be a set of, you know, SFDX commands is there. Instead of typing everything here, you will be using VS Code with the extension. So VS Code with the extension makes life easier for you. Let's say if you want to create a project in the sense, instead of typing the you know, SFDX commands, Salesforce CLI commands, you can go for Control Shift P. So if you are using Windows, this is the command palette. This is called command palette. To get the command palette, you will be going for the shortcut Control Shift P. So to create a project, you will be going for create project with manifest. I can able to easily see create project with manifest. I can able to see all the SFDX commands also there. Okay. So to make these things to happen, you should have your extension. So that's why we installed a Salesforce CLI extension there. So no need of typing the commands in the command prompt. That is being eliminated. Okay. So that is what all about the extension is about. Okay. So you have to install your Java also. And the VS Code, I told about the integration and extension pack. I told about, you know, Salesforce extension pack. That is the only pack you can able to install it. So now the remaining things are how you can able to start it. We will see that practically. Okay. Okay. So first, a little bit introduction to HTML based programming, HTML and JavaScript based programming. Let's say if you are going to do your, you know, actually LWC based programming, in the sense here, this is an LWC based project in a simple component. In the simple component, it generally contains a HTML file, a JavaScript file will be there. Okay. So the JavaScript file will contain your JavaScript code. It is based on the ECMAScript standard is there. So it is better to have, you know, what is meant by JavaScript initially, in the sense it may be, you know, making sense to go for the LWC part. So suppose, you know, I'm going to build a simple, you know, JavaScript based application. So I'm going for Notepad. I'm going to create a simple application. So a HTML based application generally starts with the tags only. The same tags you will be using in, you know, Aura component, and you will be using in Visual Force pages. This is a basic HTML. It's a markup. HTML in the sense it's a markup. It won't throw any errors. You will be, you know, making the user interface a little bit beautiful. So that's what all about markup is all about. So I'm going to give a simple, you know, a body tag. Inside that, I want to have a button. So if I need a button in the sense, I can go for input. Type is equal to button. I want to something in the button to be displayed as click me or something, in the sense I can go for value. The same thing you did in the, you know, Aura components also. Let's say click me. Now JavaScript is concerned. So why are you will writing your JavaScript? As far as web based application is concerned, you can have your JavaScript as a separate file, or you can have it as an, you know, included in the same HTML file. That is called inline based JavaScript. As far as the LWC is concerned, you will be having a separate JavaScript. Okay. So as a beginner, how it will be look like in a simple HTML file, in the sense you can have the script tag in the HTML file itself. You can have a script tag in the HTML file itself. Okay. So let me go for this is a simple script tag. In the script tag, you can write your JavaScript code. Let's say in a JavaScript, if you are going to write a function, okay, function, you might be, you know, familiar with functions because of Visual Force page and LWC and Apex, you will be writing functions only. Okay. So to write a function in JavaScript, you will be going for function and function name. So let me put my function name as display, in the sense this will be the function. And in ECMAScript, plenty of standards being released in the ECMAScript. It's better to know a couple of things. When you have a free time, please go through the things. What is mean by arrow function? In JavaScript, please go through what is mean by arrow function. Okay. And what is mean by a higher order function? It will make it easy for you to work in, you know, LWC. Higher order function, you can work for higher order function. You can go for higher order function, and you can check it out, let versus var. What is the difference between let and var? And these couple of things will make easy for you to work in LWC. And how to create a single object. Okay, how to create a single object. So these all are the basic things and arrays. Because in LWC, you will be working around these kinds of, you know, data structure, whether it might be an object or it may be an array of objects. That will be the data structure you will be doing in LWC. Primitive, apart from primitive data types. Primitive data types in the sense you will be having integer or something like that. So these are all the things, you know, it's better to learn initially. Okay, fine. So as far as JavaScript is concerned, how you can declare a variable? You can declare a variable like this, where x is equal to 10. Okay, so this is a simple variable called the x. Okay, so JavaScript is concerned, there is no need to specify the data types. You can specify like this also. Okay, let's say y is equal to, I'm going to put like this, y is equal to some name. You can specify a string like this. There is no data type right over there. So implicitly it will convert into a data type. Let's say x is now an integer data type because you are going to store an integer variable called 10. If I am going to store x is equal to the same name here in the sense, now it is possible. Okay. Immediately what JavaScript does is, you know, it will convert the data type of x into a string. So in the first line, it converts it into an, you know, a integer. And in the second line, it automatically converts it into, you know, a string data type. If you are going for, you know, conventional programming languages like, you know, .NET, C sharp or Java in the sense, if you are going to declare a variable as in Apex 2, if you are going to declare a variable integer x is equal to 10 in the sense, you can't store string. Okay, you can only, you know, the variable only can accommodate an integer variable. But as far as this particular, you know, JavaScript is concerned, it accommodate any different data types in a single variable. It will dynamically change its data type. So that's what one of the feature in JavaScript. So as far as variable declaration is concerned, you can go for var or the ES6 standard, you can go for let y is equal to 100. So two ways of declaring variables in JavaScript. So as far as this let and var is concerned, var is a, you know, it's a kind of, you can call it as a global scope. You can call it as a global scope in the sense, I'm going to declare a variable right away var x here in the sense, it will be available to all the functions. As far as let is concerned, it is a block level. We will see a little bit deeper. Okay, as of now, so this is what all about variables. Just to get a little bit touch to variables, I told you these kinds of things. Okay, I have to put something in the screen in the sense in JavaScript, you will be going for alert. So let me go for alert. Hi, welcome. So this is my simple message to the user. This is called a dynamic way of doing the things. Okay, so in the client side, if you want to do some dynamic kind of things in the sense, you will be going for your HTML. So my HTML contains simply a JavaScript block and it contains a basic button right over there. That's it. So when I'm going to click this button, this function needs to be called. As far as the function is concerned, it's an event driven. Any function you make it as an event driven in the sense, when your user is going to click, you have to execute this function. If that is the case in the sense, you have to write a listener for your button. Okay, so I'm going to write the listener on click. When the user is going to click my button, I need this, you know, display function to be get executed. So I'm going to call a display right over there. Okay, so this is what a simple HTML file with JavaScript is concerned. So let me save this and test it. Let me save it in the desktop. I can give it display.html. So let me save it as display.html. Okay, fine. So now it's time to run the file at display.txt. Okay, so let me go for it. Open with Google Chrome, let it run. So when I click this button, automatically see here, hi, welcome is coming up in the screen. So this is a simple HTML file, you know, you created. And now, you know, when I go for a right click in the browser, I'm going for, you know, inspect in the sense, you can able to see what all are the things you typed in the HTML page, everything will be available for you. Okay, so that is what HTML is all about. You can able to see the source code. If you go for right click and view page source, you can able to see the entire source code. So someone want to create a beautiful page like you, in the sense he can simply copy paste the code and he can make use of it. So when going for, you know, page design, when you're going for client side programming, that is pure HTML, in the sense you can't have your business logics right over there. Okay, anyone can able to steal it. As far as JavaScript is concerned, browser will have the capability to run your JavaScript. Let's say I want to find out 5 plus 10, I can simply give it in the browser. There is no need to write up any program for that. So in your browser, if you come for console, right click inspect, if you come for console, you can do the same thing. Let's say the same welcome message I want to generate, in the sense you can do it using your console itself. Alert, let's say I'm going to put welcome right over here, welcome, and if I click enter, see here automatically welcome is coming up. So this is what the power of your browser. Browser can process any, you know, JavaScript or HTML. There is no need to write a, you know, a file. You can test it here also. As a developer, you should know how to test it. And one more functionality is there. As far as developer is concerned, you can go for console.log. To display something in the screen, you can go for alert or you can go for console.log. Okay. Console, let me put something high there. Okay. When you put console.log, in the sense, automatically the thing will be available here in the console. So let me go for click me and alert is comes up. Automatically see here, hi is coming up. So when you're going for debugging your application, this will be very much handy for you. So as far as the developer is concerned, debugging is really very, very important thing. So you can easily debug your, you know, HTML or JavaScript based applications using the console.log. You can make use of this console.log in your LWC application also. You can put a console.log and you can check the intermediate results also. Okay. And you can go for the network kind of thing. What all are the files were being processed? As far as the debug is concerned, you can do that also. We will see in the upcoming sessions how to debug using browser. Okay. In the browser will give you a lot of, you know, powerful debugging things right over here. So this is what a simple HTML is all about. So HTML may contain a JavaScript or it may contain a CSS. I does not have any CSS right over there. Okay. So this is what the flow is all about. So generally, a function name will start with function and then you will be having the, you know, the function name. This is the conventional way. If these days, you know, when you come for LWC, there is no need to specify function keyword. You can simply put like this. Okay. And as far as the arrow function is concerned, in ECMAScript, you will be having, you know, so many things, additional things right over there. We will see one by one in the LWC session. Okay. So this is what a simple HTML is concerned. If you have any doubts, in the sense, you can ask. Otherwise, we will start create our first LWC application. So anyone has any queries here? So probably Ritu, Sudha, and Manju might have seen this in the Aura classes also. Okay, fine. So yeah. How to create? Yeah.
We've seen
this. Okay, that's fine. So how to create a simple LWC application? First, you need to open your, you know, VS Code. VS Code, you can click and open it, or from your command prompt also you can able to open it. Let's say I am in the command prompt. If I want to open my VS Code, in the sense, I can simply give code dot. That's it. My VS Code will automatically open up. Okay. So this is a simple way from the command prompt. It's better to, in the command prompt, go into your directory. From there, you just open it. It will be easy for you, rather than going for file, open directory, open folder. Instead of that, what you can do is, better you come to your command prompt, jump into your folder. Let's say I have a lot of folders here. So let me, you know, documents is my folder, in the sense. So let me do like this. It will make it a little bit faster. You can do this. CD documents is my folder. I just simply type DO and tab, automatically documents will come. There is no need to type entire thing right over here. Just enter. And then you can go for code, in the sense, automatically code is your current working directory. From the current working directory, the code editor will open. Now see here, I can able to see automatically, you know, all the contents available in my documents. I can able to see it. Okay. So in that way, it is better to get into the command prompt from your working folder. You try to open it. This will minimize, you know, normally you will be going for file, open folder, you have to search, that time will be minimized. You can do like this. So to create a simple, you know, LWC based component, after setting up CLI extensions and everything, you will be going for create project. Okay, so project can be created in two ways. It's better to create a project with manifest. Okay, manifest in the sense it will automatically contain an XML file. The XML file will decide what all are the, you know, type of pages, whether your home page or your, you know, your record detail page, what all are the pages need to host your LWC component. You can decide that using, you know, going for create project with manifest. So control shift P, note it down. In Windows, it is control shift P. Then it will automatically open your command prompt. And in the command prompt, you can go for create project with manifest. So when you click create project with manifest, automatically it will ask you whether you are going for standard or empty template or something. I am going with standard template. Standard template in the sense there will be by default, you know, the project structure will be there. No, there is no need for you to create the project structures, you know, separately. Everything will be there. That is called a template is all about. I'm going for standard template. Once I click the standard template, it will ask me to give the project name, enter the project name. Okay, let's say first LWC is my project. In the sense, I can give first LWC project. I can give like this. This is not LWC component. Keep it in mind. You are just creating a project structure. That's it. Now, you know, it will ask you where you want to store it. Okay, let me store in this particular folder itself. And you are, you know, this will trying to create a project for you. It will take a little bit time to create the project. Okay, your SFDX commands will be running behind the scene and it will create a project for you. Now you had a simple project structure for you. Your project structure is created. As far as this project structure is concerned, have a close look at it. You will be having a folder called Force App. Okay, I think you can able to see it. Is it fine for you or pretty small?
No, we can see. Yeah,
it's you can good. See. So then it's no issue. No need to complicate things. Okay, fine. You will be having a folder called Force App. Okay, so try to expand this Force App. Force App is there. Now you can go for expand this particular folder. See here, you will be having applications folder, you will be having Aura, you will be having classes. You can able to fetch all the things from your org, and you can keep your local environment also. To do that, actually there is a plugin called, you know, org browser. See here, you can able to see a cloud symbol in my system, right? In a different editor, the same editor, I have a different copy here. Here you will be having an org browser. When you go for org browser, see here, if an org is already, you know, authorized, it will try to fetch all the information from my org. It may take a little bit time for you initially because it will try to fetch all your, you know, LWC components, all your Aura components, all your Apex classes, everything will be pulled and it will be stored into your local environment. You can do the things and after that you can go for fetch. Okay, so this is one of the very beautiful tool as far as this org browser is concerned. You can have your local copy of things in your system. Okay, so as far as LWC is concerned, you will be having a folder called LWC. You can click that folder. Currently this LWC folder is empty because we haven't created any LWC project. We just now created a project. We haven't created any component. You can say like that. You haven't created any LWC based component. To create a LWC based component, you will be going for Control Shift P. Okay, again, command palette, you have to come. Command palette, control shift to P. Sometimes the plugins may take time to load. So yeah. So create Lightning Web Component. Okay, see here, create Lightning Web Component. When you select this particular, you know, create Lightning Component or create project, behind the scene, your Salesforce CLI, SFDX commands will be running. Instead of typing those commands and creating the project, you are using your editor as well as the extension. So it makes life easier and very fast, rapid development. You can able to do it. Otherwise you can do it in the command prompt itself. You can able to do it. Okay. Why it is there? I'm not sure. So Java home path needs to be set. Okay. It is showing error. I had my Java home path set. I am not sure. So let's check it out. Create a Lightning Web Component. So to create a Lightning Web Component, you have to go for create Lightning Web Component. It will ask, you know, the desired file name. So my component is, I'm going to use first LWC comp. So that is what my component. So let me enter it. So then it will ask, you know, in which directory you want to place this Lightning Web Component. I want to place the Lightning Web Component in the default directory itself. What is the default directory? FOSAP, main default, and LWC. It's better to have the same structure. Okay, I'm going to click it. See here at the bottom, SFDX create Lightning Web Component. Actually, the thing is, behind the scene, a Salesforce CLI command is being running and it will create a Lightning Web Component for you. Okay, but to create a Lightning Web Component, before that, you know, it is being created. Okay, it is being created. But after creating the project, it is better to go for authorize and arc. Okay, going for authorize and arc. When you are going for authorize and arc, in the sense, you are giving the authority that this is my arc. When I am going to push the LWC component, it should automatically go to this particular arc. To give that authorization, you will be going for authorize and arc. You can go for control shift P, okay, and you can go for authorize and arc. So first you have to select the root, selecting the root. So control shift P, you can go for authorize and arc. You can go for authorize and arc. And here there is a mechanism, authorize a dev hub or authorize a sandbox. Couple of things are there. In the first session, I don't want to get it confused that between the sandbox and dev hub, those kinds of things. So keep it pretty simple to start, to kickstart your LWC, create your project with manifest and then authorize an arc. Okay, we created LWC project too, but better it is before that you go for authorize an arc. If you go for authorize an arc, in the sense, automatically it will open a particular, your browser window and it will ask you to log in. Okay, so let me try that. Control shift P, authorize an arc. It will try to, so when you go for authorize an arc, what is your default arc you are going to do? Whether you are going for production or whether you are going for sandbox or it is a custom login URL, whatever it may be, you can choose it. So probably as a Salesforce developer, we'll be having the login.salesforce.com. So that's a project default, or you can go for production. So whatever it may be, you can choose it. I'm going for project default. Okay. And then it will ask for enter an alias. You can skip it. Just press enter. Now see here at the bottom, it is trying to authorize an arc. When if it is going to authorize an arc, in the sense, automatically your browser will open. Okay, what is the default browser set in your system? It will automatically open and it will ask you to authorize your arc. Okay, so once you specified your username and password here, okay, once you specified your username and password, it will get into your browser. The authorization part will be completed. Now you can able to close this. You can able to close this, the browser also, but it is better to keep it because again, you will be pushing your component into it and you will be checking it out. Let's see here. I can able to see, this is the window. Yeah. Okay. So you are successfully authorized to your, Lightning Web Component. Okay. So you can see that terminal. If you want to see all the happenings here, you can go for the terminal and all the things will be available in the terminal. When you're running, you can able to see the things right over here. The terminal will show what all are the processes being processed. You can able to see it. As far as this editor is concerned, when you are going to typing your things, it's better to click this particular first icon. See here, Explorer. If you click this particular icon, the sidebar will gone. Okay, now it will be the complete, full screen will be available for you. You can start, creating your application. Let's say if I want to open my, HTML file, in the sense, again, I can click it. Okay, you can go for your HTML file right over here. Okay, now you are going to work in the HTML file, switch it. Okay, now it's here. At the top corner, you have split editor window. When I go for split, in the sense, see here, I can able to see two things at the same time. I can able to see it. Because this is my JavaScript file and this is my HTML file. Sometimes, instead of switching between these two files, you can have a split window. Okay, let's say you have a 42 inch monitor right over there, in the sense, you can go for split. It will be easy for you. You can write your HTML codes in the right side. Immediately you can come to your JavaScript part and you can write your JavaScript code, because sometimes you need to know what is the component ID I had given. That will be useful for you to in your JavaScript to reference that particular file. And If you are doing it in the, you know, you may have some properties in the JavaScript file, you may need to refer it in the HTML file. Again, instead of going for switching between the files, if you have a splittered window, you can do it in the right side. Straight away in the left side, you will be having all the variables available for you. And so this is not a mandatory kind of thing, mandatory kind of stuff to do. This is, you know, how to increase your productivity as far as, you know, LWC development is concerned using the editors. The editors gives, you know, a lot of productivity for you. You can go a little bit fast. If you don't want it in the sense, you can, you know, close it, or you can go for so many kind of, you know, so many strict windows, you can go for it. This is the best way to do the things as far as the editor is concerned. So next, come to the, you know, come to your component part. Okay. As far as the component part is concerned, by default, you will be having a folder created. Once you created a LWC component, automatically a folder will be created, and your folder will contain a HTML file. It will contain a JavaScript file, and it will contain a meta file also. This is called the meta file. And at the same time, you know, when you have a look at it, you will be having some additional configuration files also. Additional configuration files also there. So let me go to this particular manifest folder. This is at the root level. This is not inside the LWC folder. This is at the root level. You have a manifest file. Okay. So when creating the project, I told that create a project with manifest. Okay. I created in such a way. I created that create a project with manifest. Actually, when you go for creating a project with manifest, in the sense, you will be having these kinds of things in your, this particular package.xml file will be automatically created for you. When you haven't gone for, you know, create project with manifest, simply you go for, let's say, let me go to the root and let me try like this. If I go for, you know, still it is in the root. Okay. If you go for simply create project, in the sense, okay. So if you go for, you know, see here, these two options, create project and create project with manifest. If you go for create project, in the sense, you will not get this particular, you know, manifest file. So as far as this manifest file is concerned, this manifest file will make, you know, let me save it. Okay, let's close it. One second. This manifest file will contain, you know, all these stuffs, like what all are the Apex classes you want to load, or you want to load Apex component, or you want to have Apex pages. So everything you can able to develop in your VS Code editor, and you can deploy it. So this is what the advantage of having a manifest file right over there. Okay. I need to make it. So let me close it, close all, and go for it, and go for my HTML file. So this is what my HTML, again, come to the picture. So this is what your global package.xml file is all about. Okay. So as far as the LWC is concerned, you will be having another XML file called meta.xml file. This meta.xml file is, you know, it's really very, very important. Initially, when you are going to push your project into the org, in the sense, sometimes it may not be available there. Okay. So you have to make your component available for different kinds of pages. If that is the case, in the sense, you have to do a couple of changes in your meta.xml file. First, initially, you have to make this particular file, LWC component, available for, you know, the end user. So you are going for is exposed is equal to true. And after that, you have to specify a couple of targets. You can go for target. Okay. You can go for target. The target should contain the closing tag. You can go for it, the target. Okay. Inside the target, you can specify what all are the pages you want to have this LWC component. Okay. I want to have lightning. I want to have the lightning app page to have this particular component. And I can have my home page, and I can have my record detail page also. So it is better to go like this, lightning-app page. Sorry, it's underscore, lightning underscore, you can go for it. Okay. So this is underscore, and this is also underscore, you can go for a record page, and you can go for home page. You should have this particular tag available for you. Okay. Record page and home page. Underscore, underscore. if you have this particular tags inside your metadata XML, now this particular LWC component, that is my first LWC component, will be available for Lightning app page, Lightning record page, and it will be available for my Lightning home page also. Okay. And you can add a master label also. Suppose if you want to something in the, you know, you want to change the default name of your Lightning component in the user interface, in the sense, you can go for it. Okay. So let me like do like this. So if you did like this, see here, the title, you can change the title right over here. Okay. So you can change it. Okay. My first LWC comp. You can give like this. Actually, see here, your component name is first LWC comp. That is what your component. When you deploy it, it will be available as my first LWC comp. Okay. When you are, if you want to change the name in the interface, in the sense, you can go for master label. So these kinds of configuration related with a particular component. It is not all the component. It is related with a particular component. So what are the things you can, you know, configure related with the particular component, you will be doing with the LWC component. The overall, overall picture is concerned, project is concerned, you can go for, you know, your manifest package.xml file. So this is what my manifest, sorry, meta file is concerned. And I have a HTML file. So by default, your HTML file will contain a template. That's it. This is a default tag available for you. Okay. Just like in Aura, just like in VF page, Apex page, you will be having a tag. So underlying working principle is same. When you are going to compare it with HTML, you can call this is a head tag. This is a HTML tag. You can call it, or you can call it as a, this is a body tag. You can call it whatever it may be. You can compare like that. This is a body tag. What are the things you want to display to the user? You can have it in your body tag. So template is also a kind of body tag. Just I want to display something in the screen. So I'm going for H1. Welcome. Okay, it's full of welcome. Okay, it's welcome LWC. Let's say this is what the thing I want to display in my component. That's it. Okay, so let me save it. Let's come to the next file. And you have an JavaScript file also. As far as this JavaScript file is concerned, you will be having a couple of ECMAScript standards. Import in the sense, if you want to create an LWC, by default, you need to have the reference for Lightning element. Lightning element is a built-in class. It is available for you to create an LWC. You need to refer that Lightning element. How you can, you know, include this? If it is an Aura in the sense, you can do like this. In Aura, Aura component, you will be having that particular attribute called, you know, implements, and after that you will be specifying your interfaces. Okay, so interface also a kind of class. In the same way, in ECMAScript standard, as far as JavaScript is concerned, to include the reference into your JavaScript, you will be using the keyword called import. Okay, and let's come to export. If you want to make your JavaScript file available for other components or available for, you know, use, you will be exporting it. Okay. So export in the sense you are making it available outside. That is called export. Okay. So by default, a class will be automatically created. The class will contain the name of your component name. My component name is first LWC. Extends. What is mean by extends? Probably people, you know, who might have seen the inheritance concept clearly, might have seen that, right? Extends is a keyword which is used to inherit. Extends used to inherit things. Okay, inherit. Let's say Lightning component is a class. The Lightning components contains so many functionalities, so many functions, so many variables inside it. If I want to use, as far as, you know, OOPS concept is concerned, if you want to use this Lightning element, you have to create object for that Lightning element. So to minimize that, what I am doing it, just I am extending it. If I extend that Lightning element, in the sense, there is no need to create object for this class, I can straight away use the functionalities which are available public to me. Okay. So that is the power of using, you know, extends. That is, you are doing an inheritance in the JavaScript itself. So this is what here. Okay. So as far as my JavaScript is concerned, there is no logics right over here. So what all are the logics you can have? The logics will have the client-side based logics. You should not have a server-side logics right over here. Let's say I want to fetch the contact information. You can't write a SOQL right over here. The SOQL is a business logic. Your business logic will reside in your Apex file. So If you want to get the data from your you know, org, in the sense, you will be using Apex or some other, you know, Lightning data services, and you will be importing the data into your Lightning web component. As far as this JavaScript is concerned, you please take it as it is just supporting rendering and data passing. That's it. Okay. Let's say you may have more than one component. To communicate between the components, you can make use of this JavaScript. Or if you want to change the content which is available, let's say I'm having a heading called welcome. I want to change the content. Instead of welcome, I want to put my name, in the sense, AJ Skills, in the sense, I can use this particular JavaScript. So JavaScript always deal with your client side, you know, manipulation of things, client side data processing. That's it. It is not going to play any role, you know, your business logics, writing the business logics right over here. So JavaScript can be used for a validation purpose. JavaScript can be used, you know, to call an your server side functionality. That will be, it will taken care. Otherwise, nothing, your business logics will not going to write over here, sit here. Because if you are going to write your business logic in the sense in the JavaScript, I will open your page, right click and view source, I can able to get all the business logics. You may spend you know, a couple of years to write all the business logics. In a single you know, 5 minutes, I can able to copy paste your business logic. So as far as web standard is concerned, your business logic will always reside in server side programming only. So this is a simple JavaScript. Nothing is going to be here. First, initially let it plain as it is. So just a HTML file and JavaScript. Initially, I told that a page may contain, you know, CSS. Okay, it may contain a CSS. By default, there will not be any CSS right over here. There will not be any CSS right over here. Actually, you can include a CSS. To include a CSS, you can go for your component, right click, you can go for new file. Okay, so what all are the files you can able to include additionally? You can include a CSS file, and you can include a SVG file also, you can able to include. Okay, simple vector graphics, you can also include in your component. What is the use of CSS? Just for styling purpose, you know that. What is meant by simple vector graphics? Let's say for my component, I want to have my own icon. Okay, I want to change the icon. By default, the LWC icon will be there. I want to change the icon, LWC icon in the sense. So let me open it, open the org and show you. So let me try to debug this page, edit this page, sorry. Let me edit this page. You will be having all the components, you know, already available there. So what you are going to develop, you are going to build a custom component. The custom component can be built using Aura component or LWC. All the components will be available here. Okay. So let's see here, by default, there is an icon is there. If you want to change this particular icon, and if you want to have your own icon in the sense, then you can go for, you know, the SVG file you can include. So we will see it in the upcoming session, how to create an SVG file and you can have your own icon. Okay, so these are the two possibilities. Additionally, you can have it. So currently we don't have anything. We have a simple, you know, HTML file. Now it is time to push it into the org. So now you finish the development part in locally, but you have to make the local development to be available in the org. If that is the case, in the sense, you have to deploy it. You have to deploy it. So you will be having an option called deploy source to org. Okay. You'll be having SFDX and deploy source to org. Deploy source to org. If you are unable to see that, in the sense, you can do simply like this. You can select it. Okay. There will be a deploy source to org. Okay, there is a Java issue is happened right where in the editor, so that's why it is not showing. Otherwise, let me come here. This is another editor. I'm going for it. See here, you will be having deploy source to org. Okay, so you can go for Control Shift P. So you can go for deploy source to org. You can go from the command palette, Control Shift P. You can go for a deploy source to org. See here, deploy this source to org. Or you can right click your component and you can go for a deploy source to org. Right click your component and you can go for a deploy source to org. Whatever it may be, you can able to do that according to your wish. So, okay, so welcome to LWC components. Let me change it and try to push it into the org. Right click, deploy the source to org. Now what will happen is, you know, this will trying to deploy. In the right hand side, you can able to see this at the bottom. Now it is being deployed to the Arc. Okay. So previously you should authorize your Arc. So before doing that, please keep in mind, you have to authorize your Arc initially, then only you can able to deploy. So you should authorize an Arc. It may be a sandbox, or it may be, you know, a scratch Arc, whatever it may be. We will see how to create a scratch Arc in the next session. This is how you can able to deploy it. So let's deploy it. Sometimes you may face issue with these extensions. I'm having so many extensions. So if one extension stopped, in the sense, the continuous extensions will not load. So it is better to have a minimum extensions, but I have no other way. So now it is being deployed. Deployed source to Arc successfully. Now you can see this particular component in your Arc. So if this is my Arc, in the sense, let me refresh this. All the components will be available here. What are the custom components you build, it will be available here. Now I can able to, you know, easily drag and drop my component. Let's say this is my component. What is my component? This is hello LWC, hello LWCS. So let's go for hello LWCS. Let's say this is my lightning component, in the sense, let me drag and drop and place it. Okay, let me drag and drop and place it. I can able to see a particular component. So whatever the components you build, it will be available for you. Okay, you can drag and drop and you can place it. You can place any component, LWC component, you can able to paste it right over here. Okay, and you can save it, and you can save this particular thing, and you can go for it in the back. You try to create a component and try to build it. Now your components will be available for you. Okay, this is a different component. It is being built using LWC. Okay, so I have two Arc authorized, so that's why I have issue. This is one Arc I authorized, this is the another Arc I authorized, so that's why my issue. So you can, this way you can able to deploy it into your Arc and you can test it. So this is the first step. And the second step, you can go for setting the debugging in your Arc. So this is also, it's better to do it, but you should do this in the development Arc, don't do this in the production Arc. So you can go for debug. Okay, the second thing you can able to do this. See here, you can able to see, you know, the buffer level or the things you can able to see it at the top. So for that, you can go for, you know, debug mode. You in the setup, you go for debug mode, click it. You will be carried over to the next page. The available users will be displayed right over here. Select your system admin account. If I am the system admin, in the sense, let me select this particular, you know, system admin account and go for enable. Once you enable, in the sense, the cache problems will not be happen. You can able to clear the things by clicking this particular button. So let me remove it. I already enabled it. So in the debug mode, now you can able to see this green color thing with the information. Okay, when you click it, it will be automatically be refreshed. It will ask you to clear the storage. If you click OK, in the sense, it will be okay. So the cache kind of things can be removed, but it's better to use it in the developer mode only, developer Arc only. Don't do it in the production Arc. Okay, so this is how you can able to build a simple Lightning web component, and you can push it. Okay, please make sure only one authorized Arc right over there, and you try to push it. Okay, for demonstration purpose, I have a couple of things to show the things, because sometimes the extension may take time to load. So that's why I already, you know, created your component and shown you in the different editor. It may take a little bit time to load. So to reduce that, I demonstrated like that. So first, what you can do is you can create a simple lightning web component. First step, create a project with manifest. Don't forget in the manifest, don't forget to put these things. Don't forget to put your targets right over there. Initially, the targets will not be there, and easy exposed will be false. You try to change it into true and try to include these targets. Okay, that is the first step. After finishing the thing, you can go for, you know, authorize an Arc. You can create LWC project and you can deploy source to Arc. You can drag and drop in your, you know, home page or record detail page. You can test it. Okay, so if possible, try to test this. Try to install Arc browser in your system, and see here, I ran it, you know, a couple of minutes later, I ran this particular Arc browser. Now I can able to see what all are the things available in my Arc. Everything is being here. Okay, when I go for Apex classes, in the sense, currently all the available Apex classes will be now available for me in the local development. So these many Apex classes I had returned, I had in my Arc. Everything is available right now. See here, account insert. If I click this, in the sense, it will download. At the right side, you will be having an option called download. So you can download it. See here, automatically it will be running. The org will be, you know, the SFDX command will be running, and it will download the particular class, and you will be able to see it in your screen. Now it is available for you, you know, to your local development. You can do the development part, and after that you can push it back. So this is how, you know, you can develop locally using your VS Code editor, and you can push it into your org. There is no need to do it in the developer console. Okay, so a particular period is crossed. Initially, you will be practicing with your developer console. After a particular stage, you want to be a more professional way, in the sense, this is the more professional way to do it with the editors. So whatever the thing, if you are going for a SOQL or you are going for Apex class or Aura components, you try to practice everything using your VS Code editor. So these are all the things you need to make it mandatory, and org browser and extensions. Okay. So this is what all about the introduction sections. If you have any queries, any doubts, in the sense, you can go for it. In the upcoming classes, we will be seeing binding of data. What is mean by track? What is mean by API? What is the differences? Everything we will see. So before that, before moving into the next class, you try to have a hands-on experience on this particular, you know, creating and deploying a simple component. Sometimes so many issues you may face. So that's why, you know, I'm asking you to practice a simple LWC component and push it. Do you have any queries here?
So how we will download that org browser?
Org browser will be available for you in the extensions. You go for extension. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
In the extensions, as I told, better to include prettier, better to include the formatter kind of, you know, extensions also. That is what the power of, you know, see here, the coloring and the bracketizer, the brackets are being highlighted. It is, you know, it's really very handy. Okay. Any programming language, you can program it in the VS Code editor. This will make you sense. Okay. So try to use VS Code editor when you have time to build anything in Salesforce. So try to practice a simple LWC component and push it. I will share this particular, you know, this PDF also. I will share it. So that's it for the day. If you have any queries, in the sense, you can ask any doubts or anything. Those who are already familiar with LWC, so in the upcoming classes, we will see all the components. Okay. So the data binding and the data passing, data flow, and one more beautiful thing. So recently you have a local development server also. Okay. So that is also, we are going to see in the, in our classes. I'm not sure whether it is being included in the topic or not, but we will see how to use a local development server. Local development server, in the sense, see here, you are building the LWC component, and to test that component, you are pushing it into your org. Okay. So you have to wait for so long to push it into the org, and after that you have to get into the org, and you have to drag and drop, and you have to test it. So it is in the development stage. In the development stage, you know, you can do it in the locally. So for that, there is a plugin called the local development server currently available. So the local development server will be running in your system only. You can build the component, and you can easily debug, and you can easily see how the component behaves from locally itself. Once you are satisfied, then only you can go for pushing it into the org, deploy the source into org. Otherwise, you can test and do the things in the local itself. So another way of rapid development using local development server. So that's also we will see in the upcoming classes. Okay. So that's it for the day. So if you have any queries, in the sense, you can ask. Otherwise, we will wind up the session.
Mention prettier, and which one is the other one you asked to
install? Local development server.
Okay.
Local development server, in the sense, no need to go for a deploy to org initially. You can test it locally. If the functionalities are fine, then finally you can go for deploy to org. Okay. Oh. Yeah. That is the recent development being happening here in LWC. Okay. So many opportunities exist for LWC. So it's actually easy to learn LWC if you have little bit idea in JavaScript, and JavaScript is the core thing. That's what I already told a couple of, again, I'm telling the couple of concepts. When you have your free time, please go for it. ECMAScript 6, and ECMAScript 6 is the base. ECMAScript 6, you go for higher order function, because we are going to see all the things here also. So higher order functions, what is mean by higher order functions, and arrow functions, So you try to go through these things, let and where kind of stuff. So because and asynchronous communication, okay, so that is all about then. So those kinds of things, you know, asynchronous communication, that is also, these all are the JavaScript standards we are going to play with the LWC. If you are strong in these things, you can able to do the things, you know, easily in LWC. So this is the core part. Two things. One is, you know, the design part. The design part is all about using the components. As far as the design is concerned, there is no need to keep all the things in mind. Okay. When design comes into picture, in the sense, you can go for lightning. You can go for lightning component library. So it will be readily available for you. You can just copy paste the code and you can take it. Okay. No issue with that. So where will be the issue? The logic, that really matters. So how you will build the logics by doing, you know, so many programs. So see here, all the components will be available. It can be categorized, as we told earlier, it can be categorized into two way. Let's say I want to have a simple card. So if I want to have a simple card, in the sense, I will be having card component in LWC as well as I'm having card component in R also. So almost, you know, in the previous classes I told already, you know, the syntax is pretty much similar. Only difference is, instead of hyphen, you will be having colon. See here, in LWC, you will be having a hyphen here. In Aura components, for the same card, you will be having colon right over there. The functionality is mere same. Okay. See here, you will be having colon here. So these things, it's really very tough. Personally asking, it's really very tough to keep all the tags in my mind. Okay. But what you need to keep it in mind is, what all are the components available? Yeah, a little bit picture. That's enough. You can type it and you can get it. And when you have a free time, you try this with these components. You have a playground right over here at the right side. You can drag and drop your component and you are copy paste your components, and you can immediately see the pictures right over here, how it behaves. There is no need to go for VS Editor 2. Okay. So this is what the output you are getting. This is what, you know, my design is concerned. The design's corresponding output is right over here. To check with the component reference, you can copy and you can paste it in the playground, and immediately you can get a picture. There's no need to install anything right over here. So in that way, you can a little bit, you know, strong with the component reference. And one more part is, you know, as we know, SLDS. SLDS also going to play an important part. If you want to make your component looking beautiful, in the sense, you have to style it. So that's why the Lightning design system comes into picture. So you can take it in this way. One is the component reference, and another one is the Lightning design system. And the next one is your JavaScript part. Okay. Your ECMAScript standards, the JavaScript part. And at last, your Apex codings and your triggers. So this is the complete picture. If you are, you know, a little bit strong on these areas, you can survive in LWC easily. And if you want to be certified JavaScript developer, you have to complete your LWC super badge. You have to complete. So LWC super badge, you have to complete. Go for it. Okay, LWC super specialist badge. It is similar to Aura component. The only difference is the syntax might be different. As far as the task is concerned, it's pretty much the same task. Okay. So you can do it LWC, then automatically you will be qualified for JavaScript developer. You go for JavaScript developer, you know, certification also. If time permits, we will have special sessions on pure JavaScript also. Okay. So I'm talking with Ashok. If I have a time, we will go for that also. So this is what to make you a little bit strong on LWC. This is the way you can go for it. Okay. Anyway, thank you so much for this session. So we will see you tomorrow. It's Saturday. We will have the session on Saturday, next session. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
Thanks, bro.
Thank you. Thank you, Nagaraja.
Thanks. Thanks a lot.
Thanks.